Welcome to the Lafferty Fogger Layout Tool. This video will show you how to use the tool to create a graphic drawing of your facility and show how many foggers are needed. The layout grid is where you will draw the floor plan of the areas you wish to fog. You will overlay fog plumes to represent where foggers need to be placed in order to fully cover the area. The grid is divided into squares that each represent a 10-foot by 10-foot area, or 100 square feet each. The grid can display a space of up to 300 feet wide by 200 feet deep, a total of up to 60,000 square feet. The gray box in the corner of the grid represents the area that needs to be fogged. To adjust the size of the box, hover the mouse over an edge or the bottom right corner of the box, then click and drag. Above the grid, use the Layout Planning Toolbox to show or hide up to 4 boxes. We are going to start with a room that is 200 feet by 150 feet. Use your creativity to display the fogging area in a way that is meaningful for you and your planning efforts. For example, add different sized boxes or position them so that the entire facility or an odd-shaped room is depicted. Each new box can be resized to precise dimensions using the grid markings and then dragged into position, or a box can be moved before it is resized. You can even stack boxes to represent space within the floor plan that will not be fogged. For instance, this box could be an office, a storage room, or a restroom that will not be fogged. Or you can use overlays to represent different fogging zones within a large room or facility. Adjust your layout as much as you like until you are ready to add fogger locations. Return to the Layout Toolbox to select Fogger Plumes. From the first drop-down, select the model. From the second drop-down, select the fogger type. Then click on the Add Fog Plume button. The plume can be moved anywhere on the grid. Notice that when I hover my mouse over a plume, a control button appears that lets me rotate the plume for precise placement. Hold the Shift key down to rotate the plume in 45-degree increments. This can be really helpful with 4-way and 2-way fogger plumes. The X at the top right of the plume lets me delete it. Now place plumes so that the edges slightly overlap until the fogging area is covered. Here, I'm placing plumes for 3 zones. A programmable timer will control the fogging in each zone. Notice, to the right of the grid, the Fogger Selections table is keeping count of the plumes placed on the grid. For easy visual identification, the 633 fogger plumes are a different color than the 305 foggers. To save a copy of your work, click the Print button and print to Adobe PDF if you have that option installed on your computer. Otherwise, select your preferred print option. Here's how my PDF turned out. Your printout could appear slightly different depending on your settings. To learn more and see all of the fogging equipment that we offer, check out the Fogger's product section on the Lafferty Equipment website.